Welcome to Tech Mothership with me Suresh, and today we're going to see the latest WhatsApp tricks. So before trying these tricks, I just request you to update the latest WhatsApp app. So let's get into the App Store, I mean Play Store, and I'm just checking. Yeah, there is update. So I'm updating the WhatsApp app, and it got updated. The first thing we're going to see is dark mode. WhatsApp dark mode. What's in that? See, actually there is two major advantages of this dark mode is, first thing, like it reduces the eye strain during night time. Okay, when you're using the application during the night time, okay, if you're using this dark web mode, it reduces the eye strain. Second is when you're using the OLED phones, smartphones with the OLED display, it reduces the battery usage. So these are the two major advantages in dark mode. Okay, so let's check how to enable it in WhatsApp. To enable the dark mode in WhatsApp, first go to WhatsApp menu. Okay, then select for chat. Then there will be option like theme under the display category. If you select in that, if you tap that, you'll get two options, either light or dark. If you select dark and select give okay, the dark mode is enabled in WhatsApp. That's how the dark mode is enabled in the WhatsApp application. And sometimes if you're using the phone in outdoor, like sun, under the sunlight, okay, in dark mode the visibility will be very less. So in that case you can change it to a theme to light mode, so it will be easier for visibility and readability. That's about the WhatsApp dark mode. See, next is the WhatsApp text format. There are some basic text format inbuilt with the WhatsApp. So let's see how to send the message with like bold, italics, the handle strike, this thing. First thing, I'm going to send the text with the bold format. Okay, in that case we need to add asterisks in the front and the end of the text message, like hello world, I'm ending and starting with asterisks, so it shows us bold, and you can send the message like bold. Next thing is the italics. For italics we need to add underscore in front of the word and at the end of the word. See, same underscore, hello world underscore, and I'm going to send a message, and it's italics now. Okay, next I'm going to send a message with strike through. Okay, for that I need to add one symbol, tilde symbol, okay, at the start of the message and the end of the message. I'm going to add tilde symbol and going to send. See, that's how we are going to send the strike through message. Fourth and final format is monospace. To monospace your text, add three back ticks in front of the text and at the end of the text to monospace your message. That's how we send your monospace message in WhatsApp. These are the basic and inbuilt text format available in WhatsApp. And next thing, I'm going to show you how to add WhatsApp chat shortcut on the home screen of the Android phone. Now I'll show you how to add the WhatsApp chat shortcut to the home screen. Okay, let's go step by step. First, I'm opening a contact and I'm sending some text message, text message line. And then what you need to do, you need to tap on the three dot menu on the top right corner.
ओके To add a contact, WhatsApp contact shortcut, it's very easy. Okay, first when you get into the contact chat screen, then tap the three dot menu on the top right. Then select more option. Then there will be an option called add shortcut. So when you tap on that, there will be a shortcut added to the home screen, from which you can directly chat to your open the chat window and chat to your contact WhatsApp contact. The best next trick is like sending a message to your WhatsApp number without saying their number. I think this will benefit most of the WhatsApp users. Okay, let me show how to do that. Okay, to do this thing, first we need a link. I'll just drop this link in first comment of this video. Okay, so you can copy the code. Okay, to use this trick. Now I'm going to show you how to send a message without saving the number. First thing, I'm just opening your WhatsApp chat message, okay, where I have stored the link, and I'm just copying the link now, and it's copied. Okay, now I'm going to paste this link in the browser like Chrome or any inbuilt browser. Okay, and one more thing we need to do is like in this link there will be some XXX at the end of the link. Okay, we need to replace that XXX with our real phone number. And one more thing, we need to add like country code like 91 for India and 01 for USA, etc. And then I'm going to select, and then you just click enter. Okay, it will show a message. After clicking enter, it shows a message like continue chat, and select yes. Then it will directly take you to WhatsApp window opening the chat for us. We can directly send the message from here without saving the number. See, I'm going to send a text message, okay, like a test message, hi, test message, that's it. This is how we are going to send the WhatsApp message without saving the number in our phone. So next I'm going to use another number which does not exist in WhatsApp, okay, and see what the error message we're getting. So I'm just typing the another number. Okay, I'm just going to select enter. After typing the number, I'm just going to give enter. Okay, and it will show like continue chat. Yep, and I'm selecting tapping on continue chat, and it opens in WhatsApp, and it shows a error message called this phone number isn't on WhatsApp. So if the WhatsApp or if the number is not in WhatsApp, then it will show this kind of error message. The next we're going to see is how to check the message just been deleted by the sender. For this we need to install a third party app called WhatsApp Remote Plus. Okay, and how this third party app works is like it will read all your notification. Okay, even if the sender is deleting the message, okay, with the notification messages, it will show and retrieve the messages sent by the sender. So I installed WhatsApp Remote Plus, and it's asking for the permission to read my messages and notification access. I'm giving access to my notification. Allow. And now it will ask which are the apps it can access the notification. So I'm just selecting only on WhatsApp. And I'm giving next. Yes, save files. Even if the messages and the photos or videos are deleted by the sender, it can be retrieved. Now we're going to see how this trick going to work in real time. I'm asking my friend, one of my friend, to send some messages to my WhatsApp number. Okay, and is sending now. Through is sending hi for me. Next, I told him to send more messages actually. Yeah, your videos are awesome. Actually, I told just to show off. Next is sending. What is going to send? Next is sending. Yeah, hi Rascal. Okay. And then he messaged, sorry for what? First screwed me like. Okay, now I'm just opening the WhatsApp and checking his messages. Okay. See, now the Dhruv has deleted the message hi rascal, so this message is not appearing in my chat window and I'm getting only the message called this message has been deleted. That's it. So I'm just opening the WhatsApp remote plus. Okay, under the detected, see this message was deleted by Dhruv and we can see retrieve and see it in this app. Hi rascal has been deleted by Dhruv, but it shows up in WhatsApp remote plus. So this is how this WhatsApp Remote Plus works. Okay, and actually this WhatsApp Remote Plus is a third party app. Okay, and it will read all your messages from notification access. So if you have any privacy concern, please do not install this app and don't recommend this app if you have some personal privacy concern. We are coming to the final end of this video and this is going to be a WhatsApp web. So we can use the WhatsApp either in our laptop or desktop, okay, through browser. Okay, so to get into that, first open the browser and go to this website web.whatsapp.com. The website shows one QR code which should be scanned from our WhatsApp application in running on smartphone. Open the WhatsApp in smartphone. Okay, select menu and then select WhatsApp web and scan this QR code and both the devices will get synced and you can either send message from your WhatsApp smartphone or WhatsApp web in your from your browser. We can send even audio messages, video, picture message and text message to any of our contacts. It's very easy to send messages from our laptop or desktop. And when you're scanning the QR code, below that there will be an option called keep me signed in. We can either tick or untick. Okay, if you're using a if you're going to use this WhatsApp web in your personal computer, I recommend keep it in signed in. So whenever you close the tab and open the new tab and type this website address, visit this address, it will directly, without logging in, with it directly open the WhatsApp web. It's very easy and very useful too. That's all guys, and I'll keep you more updated with the latest WhatsApp tips and tricks. Thanks for watching this video. Please like this video. If you like this video, please share it with your friends and subscribe to my channel Tech Mahindra C. Click on subscribe button, click on the bell icon for notification about latest videos. Thank you, bye.